authorities say that the flight crew erred on the side of caution today.
But what they did frightened a lot of people, especially the passengers aboard the flight. Steve Bergen has more on how the incident unfolded. Steve?
Vicki, Rick, flight crews have been much more vigilant ever since a Nigerian man tried to bring down a jet during a flight from Amsterdam to Detroit on Christmas Day. They just aren't taking any chances.
A member of the flight crew had become alarmed.
The U.S. airplane bound for Louisville left LaGuardia Airport around 7:30 this morning. 45 minutes into the flight, the teenage passenger drew the attention of a female attendant. Joe Saturday of Louisville was on the aircraft.
I think she got scared.
He was wearing what is known as an olfactory, which is a box-like device that goes on the forehead. It has straps, leather straps emanate from it, which connects to a second device, which is connected to his arm.
The teenager cooperated with the crew, according to police, and attempted to explain the religious significance of the tefillin. At 8:22, the tower at the Philadelphia International Airport was notified of an onboard emergency. Moments later, the plane was on the ground and taken to an isolated area.
But the scariest part was the police coming on board with a 9mm, telling everybody to hold their hands up. And I never had a gun pointed at me like that.
Satterley, who shot these photos from the plane, says the teenager was taken off the aircraft and questioned by authorities on the tarmac. Within 15 minutes, they were shaking his hand. All the passengers were interviewed.
Because of New York City's close proximity to Philadelphia, there wasn't a lot of time in the air for the crew to make a determination, so they chose to err on the side of caution.
I'm happy that everybody's safe and it was just a mistake, but I think the airlines need to have some type of sensitivity training towards religious beliefs.
The Transportation Security Administration initially referred to the teenager as a disruptive passenger. But the 17-year-old reportedly cooperated with authorities every step of the way and made no threatening gestures or remarks. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.